So let's talk about programming. I'm going to use a software called VCDS. This is a software made by Rostec. You can get it. It comes with a OBD2 port reader that you hook into your computer via USB. First thing to note is that we need to program various different computer control modules, such as engine, ABS brakes, engine 2, steering wheel, instrument, and parking aid. Engine 1 is primary ECU, engine 2 is the secondary ECU, etc., etc. And there are two types of coding that you need to do. So first off, we need to hook up our car, turn it on, and hook the OBD2 reader to the VCDS dongle. We then click select. It's going to communicate with the car, and it's going to return a list of modules that's installed on this car. Let's just go ahead and enter the engine module. We are now communicating with the primary engine ECU control. One thing to note is to what you really care about is coding. Coded here, coding number 7. We're going to click here and notice that there is a current coding here. And this is represented in hexadecimal digits. It's just a series of numbers that's represented in hexadecimal format. If you're more curious about what hexadecimal format is, I've added a link so you can look up what hexadecimal format is. One thing to note before you code and change this, always copy and paste these codes into a separate file, like I did here. These codes here that I'm highlighting are the actual original codes that came with my car. There happens to be a mistake in your coding, you can always revert back to the coding that came with your car so you don't brick the module. Next thing, since this is I call long code, we need to either code it manually or use the long coding helper. There is a nice tool that VCDS has that has a bunch of lookup tables related to certain bits of these bytes here for long coding. What we care about is bytes number 4 right here, byte number 4. And I just need to change a bit here, bit 0 to 2. To either 00, 03, or 04. As you can see, my car came with 03, which was an automated manual transmission. I went ahead and changed from 03 to 00. Once I changed that, I then clicked the button called Do It to save the coding to the ECU. Next up, I want to show you the other type of coding, which is short coding. So I'm going to use, let's see here, the instrument. Actually, I'm going to use the steering wheel first. It's actually simpler. So steering wheel is number 16 right here. I'm going to go into coding, and you see the short code. And if you're lucky enough, Rostec will have a lookup of how you would code this short code format. Right here, I'm going to see these options here for either manual transmission or automatic transmission. It's either a 0 or a 1. But where do I change the digit in this short code format? And you need to follow the question mark here. It's a little bit small, but yeah, there is this question mark on the third digit that tells you this is where you need to change this digit. It's the third digit from the left, is either 0 or 1. One thing I note is in my original code here, the third digit was already 0. And it tells you that, hey, it's a manual transmission because it's true. It's not an automatic transmission like a dual clutch or a torque converter transmission. So I found that it was already there. So what I did find is that I can program out the shift paddles right here. And where do you program out the shift paddles? It's the fifth digit from the left here, that question mark. So I need to add a plus 1 to it. And my original steering wheel control right here, let's see here, it had a pedal shifter, so it was a plus one. So what I need to do, if I were to say, hey, I don't have pedal shifters because it's a manual steering wheel, I would take away one digit. I do minus one. And now my coding, my current coding is 0004041. And that is how you would read the guide for short code format. I want to go back and now look into the, let's see here, what was the instrument? Basically the instrument cluster. So let's go and code here. Here is the main thing that I found out here. For the first four digits, I actually need to add a series of numbers to get to the right configuration. What I found out that is that I had magnetic rides, I had tire pressure system, I also had a second fuel tank. I did not have a manual transmission. So what we need to do is basically add a four to the fourth digit here. So let's go to my instrument here. This was the fourth digit. The fourth digit was a one here. And if I want to tell the instrument cluster that this is a manual transmission, I would need to add a four to this one digit. So now this one becomes a five right here. So it is now 0085 instead of 0081. And that is another way for you to figure out how to code the short form coding for this specific module. Last thing I want to highlight is ABS brakes. I go into coding, and there is actually no guide for ABS brakes. Rust Tech tells you, hey, you need to email us if you need proper coding values. However, I did not have the time. I actually reached out to Johnny Bros. He actually did his manual conversion a few weeks before I did. And he told me that, yes, you basically need to take away two digits or add two digits, depending on the type of brakes you have. If you have ceramic, carbon ceramic brakes, you add a plus two to the last digit here. Let's go to Davies brakes. This is my original coding here. Oops, here. Yeah. Original coding was here. So I think I would need to add a plus two if I had carbon ceramics. However, I had iron rotors and I need to take away two from this digit. So it would turn, so this 260 would turn out to be a 258. Once you code this module, you completely exit this controller and then you could re-enter this controller again and then check for the error codes, because once you start exploring all these different modules, you can like hit this basic function to look at fault codes. And I had a couple of fault codes that the ABS module was telling me that, hey, I had a missing TCU module. So I had to code that out. And once I coded it from 260 to 258, it still showed up as an error, missing TCU. What I had to do was completely exit the ABS module and then enter it again. And then I could go ahead and clear the codes from there. And that is programming this Audi R8 in a nutshell of what you need to do to program this car. Let me just quickly touch the parking aid to show you what I programmed for parking aid. Parking A, which is 76, and which is parking assist here. Yeah. So for me, I changed the 1, 2, 3, the fourth digit from the left from 1 to 0. So here you go. This was my original code. I changed the fourth digit here, number 1, to a 0 here.